This comes unannounced, it's not on your program. But what we have in front of you, these are students from the guitar class. This is our guitar ensemble. This is under the direction of Mr. Garrett Rowe. And I'm going to give him the microphone now so that he can make his introduction.
So today, we have Skylar Berrios, Gabrielle Martin, Amanda Ferrante, Aiden Geiger, Deanna Marks, Francis Perez, Brady McGill, Kyle DeSimone, Billy King Jr., Alexis Patterson, Chelsea Singh, and Ryan Milletti. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we're recording here, sorry.
Concert Orchestra under the direction of Miss Donna, Visone-O'Brien.
excited that I can have the opportunity to work with such amazing students and amazing musicians. Thank you for supporting music. It's been a long time, 2 years since we've had a concert, and thank you so much.
Thank you. Hi, good evening. We are so excited to be here. It's been two full years since we've had people in these seats, and we couldn't be more excited. This group behind me has been absolutely unbelievable for not really having real music and singing, and they've just persevered through all of this, and I couldn't be prouder of them. So thank you so much for being here.
Our next piece is entitled Spes, which means hope in a language called Sami. Sami originates from Lapland, Scandinavia. This piece speaks of living life to its fullest and to be ourselves in the short time that we exist. The words translate to, I belong to the wind, but I live. Maybe that is the meaning of life. I live here and now. That is the way. No one has power over the wind to contain it. So no one has power over our time on earth. A person's wisdom brightens their face and changes our fears.
I believe in love, even when I feel it not.
our soloist, Rachel Summers. Our next piece, we are lucky enough to have a very talented young pianist in the choir here. Julia Baticcio will be accompanying our next piece. So come on down, Julia. Before our last two pieces, I just want to thank Mrs. Dorio, my partner in crime, for playing for us and being my buddy. And everyone, Dr. Skip, the entire music department, and our administration, we would not be able to do this without all of your support, especially for the past 2 years. I hope that everybody has a great holiday. We have two pieces left.
I don't know what to repeat.
holiday. Special thanks to my mini band over here, Mr. Singh and Rachel and Ariana and Ms. Doria. Have a great holiday.
I would like to welcome to the stage the William Floyd Concert Band under the direction of Ms. Kimberly J. Hyland.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I wanted to take just a moment to thank you all for coming to our concert tonight and to let you know how very thrilled we are to be back and performing for you live and in person once again. We are so very fortunate that we enjoy a tremendous amount of support for music education here in the William Floyd School District, from our Board of Education and District Office Administration, to our building administration and our department chairperson, to our fantastic colleagues throughout the entire district, and of course to you, our community members, who come out time and time again to show your support for everything that we do. We can't thank you enough for always being here for us and for being such a wonderful audience. I'm normally not one to spend a lot of time talking at the concert. I know that you came here to listen to them play and not to me speak, but quite frankly, they need a minute of a break to rest their chops for a second before our last song. So I told the band I would spend a minute telling you a very quick story about why we are performing this last piece on tonight's concert, just so that they can get a quick break. I usually don't program a lot of holiday music. It's not that I don't like holiday music, I really do, but we start rehearsing this music for the winter concert back in September. And I just can't seem to bring myself to be playing jingle bells and the like before Halloween. So that just doesn't work for me. So too often I wind up getting caught short on time and the music doesn't always happen for the holiday selection for our December concert. Well, 26 years ago, I first started teaching and I conducted my first concert. And my parents were in attendance at that show, just as they are here in attendance at tonight's performance. Neither of my folks are formally trained in music, but they've raised 5 children and way too many grandchildren to actually count, right here in this community for the most part. And they've come to hundreds and hundreds of concerts throughout their years. They are some of the fiercest advocates for music education that you'll ever meet, and they truly love and appreciate all of the music that we perform. But on that night, 26 years ago at my first concert, my mom said something to me that has stayed with me for all these years. After congratulating me on my band's performance of new and mostly unfamiliar works, my mom told me, "We understand that you choose music for your group based on what you want them to learn, music that will help them grow and become better performers. But don't ever forget that every once in a while, your audience would like to hear just one song that they recognize, one tune that they'll walk out to the parking lot humming along." And I stopped and I thought for a moment and I said to myself, you know what? She's not wrong. So tonight, our final selection is a collection of holiday songs that I think you'll recognize and probably be humming along to the rest of the night. This song is not only for my mom, but for all the other moms and dads and grandparents and family members out there who think just like my mom does, that every once in a while, it's nice to hear the band play something that you recognize. So, okay, story over. Did I give you guys enough time to rest? Okay, good. There we go. We hope you enjoy our final selection of the night. It's entitled A Holiday Yellow.